1991, the penalties eluded Solomon Islands. Fiji took their first ever gold medal in Lae in PNG. Let's see if this time around the penalties don't haunt them. It is a Saturday though this time. The last time was a Friday afternoon.
Maybe the details of the days could change. We'll see. Look at these players. They have been battling it out.
So the Solomon's has the first kick by the looks of it. The Caledonian goalkeeper Ricky. Wayeke.
And both teams with a lot at stake here. Well, you can see these players have done their bit in the 90th minute. Now it's up to the penalty shootout.
Oh no, it's Solomon's. New Caledonia has the first shot. So it's experienced Fonzi to take the first kick.
Against, I would say, also equally an experienced Philip Mango, who's been the goalkeeper, and New Caledonia, Fonji Ranchain. He checks. And
saves.
Brilliant save there.
Again, he dived the right side again, Philip, with that save, like he did earlier on against the captain.
Probably spent the whole game just resting for a penalty shootout. We'll see. Solomon Islands now has the task of scoring. It's their main man, the captain now, Micah Le'alafa.
Yeah, he's a good finisher, Micah. A futsal player. A good opportunity for the stand-in captain.
Goal here would definitely put confidence in the Solomon Islands penalty takers. Micah Le'alafa to convert, checks and sends it well. Solomon leading.
Yeah, and there's a good kick by Micah Le'alafa, the stand-in captain, to put Solomon's up. That will give confidence to the rest of the kickers. The crowd loving it.
Now, this player up next is probably one of my favorite players, I would have to say, Raymond. Pierre Bako is up for New Caledonia. And a goal for him would do the same, instill confidence in the next penalty taker for New Caledonia. But it's Philip Mango here. Two penalty saves already. One in the game, one in the penalty shootout. Can he do another one? Bako comes in and converts well. Mango actually goes in the right spot.
Yeah, Solomon still have the advantage. Rocky goes back, Bako goes across to give him confidence. David Supa.
Interesting choice of penalty takers. From a right back, probably he has the confidence here. So, yes, David Supa, Solomon Islands. Can he convert? Put two goals to Solomon's.
Oh, and hits the crossbar.
Hits the crossbar and we're back.
And a poor kick by David Supa has made it equal now. It's 1-1. It is painful. It is painful, a miss like that. To put too much power. As you said, he's a defender. And the defender's shot he did take.
Interesting choice there. And you speak of young players coming up. This is one here. you've mentioned when he was substituted on as probably for the penalty shootout. He's definitely up on the line.
I did say that it probably brought him for the penalty shootout.
There's Philip Mango again. Oh, good one. Good conversion there by the youngster. Philip Mango was going the right way. But good.
Richard, yeah. As I said, he probably were brought in for that penalty. He's made it count. Now Solomon's.
Kinkawa.
At Kinkawa.
Plays in Fiji. Raymond would know.
Borewa. Has to get this in.
And he scores. At Kinkawa scores. Oh, he converts well. Pressure back on New Caledonia. But still, both on two converted penalties.
We come to the fourth kicker now for the penalty shootout.
Probably one of the players that you want to take a penalty as this
one.
Yeah,
he is the leading, one of the leading goal scorers.
Luis Wire.
Luis Wire,
number 9 for New Caledonia.
A striker, a great finisher.
Look at the faces of Solomon Islands players.
He got the first goal today. Let's see what he can come up with in the penalty shootout.
Wire checks, goes up, and beaten Philip Mango, who decides to stand still in the middle. Pressure back on the Solomon Islands. There you see New Caledonia number 9 just converted. Pulling supporters.
So for Solomon.
Again, another defender here. That's the left back.
Calvin Arcio. Well, can he make up for his earlier penalty giveaway?
Pressure at such level is intense. So for these players to execute, it's a task. Here's Calvin. And sends it in. Good.
He makes it look simple, doesn't it?
Definitely. Makes up for the penalty that he did early on. Pressure back on New Caledonia. The crowd here, something about this national stadium that tells you the intensity and passion for football. And if there's one man to rectify his mistake, that's this man here.
Is this man here, or will he be the zero again, from the zero to the hero, the captain?
He's back in the same spot where he was a couple of minutes ago, against Philip Mango. Can he send Philip Mango away? And he scores. Philip Mango caught off guard. Good goal by Caesar.
Yeah, this time he makes it count, the captain.
Pressure is back on Solomon Islands here. That's their last one here. Well, we'll have to see. And it's Starman Rafael Le'ai. Look at the crowd standing. Just the feel, the vibe that you get around here.
And both sides have had one miss. And it's this gentleman here who's the darling of the Solomon Islands, their star player.
Rafa Le'ai. Can he convert? And he does. Quite neatly, not too strong. Very confident take of penalty there by Rafa Le'ai. But again, Rocky Nikin, I thought he almost got to that one as well.
Bernard Uaya.
Can Philip Mango do one more magic?
defender for the New Caledonians.
Bernard Iwa, or Iwa, can he convert? And yes, he does, sending Mango the wrong way.
Solomon's opportunity now.
Interesting to see Solomon Islands have already three defenders, including this one's going to be the third defender taking a penalty. Shows the confidence the coaching staff have on their defenders. Alan Peter, the Solomon Warriors defender. New Caledonia goalkeeper Rocky Nike probably wants to add a little bit pressure on this taker. Sets himself up. And good goal, good finish. Former defender. But Rocky Nike of New Caledonia was almost had it. Good finish.
Pressure back on, isn't it?
Back on New Caledonia.
Who will it be? That will be the criminal, sort of saying, at this.
Can Mango produce the goods here?
So, New Caledonia. Jared Waya.
A save here would definitely be spectacular. Jared Waya. Almost having
good
it.
Good penalty.
Very composed. Shows quality there. Jared Waya converts well.
Back to Solomon's now.
It's another defender here, holding midfielder rather.
Kofana.
Kofana.
Well, the Solomon Islands, it is heart breaking, isn't it? And heart stopping.
Indeed, and this man here has the responsibility. Rocky Nikin. And converts well. Brilliant penalty by Leon Kofana. Pressure back on New Caledonia here, Raymond.
Yeah, definitely. It's gone to the eighth kicker. And, so now, one miss each so far. It is 6-all. 6-all, not counting the final score. And Vincent Vakay,
Vincent,
the veteran
of New Caledonia,
probably his last tournament.
Philip Mango steadies, and he delivers. He converts
makes
well.
7. Experience in that side. They don't want to watch it.
And New Caledonia again putting pressure back on the Solomon Islands. Not with this man here, John Orobulu. He can be as confident and also clinical in front of the goal. Can he do it in a penalty spot kick of such level?
Oh, what was he thinking?
A miss here
what
by John Orobulu.
What was he thinking? The top goal scorer, John Orobulu. What was he thinking with that kick?
Way above the crossbar, and he's down, he's broken right there.
For a striker that was the leading top goal scorer in the tournament, what was he thinking, Alex?
Disappointment here for Solomon Islands, but the joy here from New Caledonia players, they know really well. That's the man here, disappointed as he is. Walking now. This is definitely a heartbreaking situation for him, for all the supporters, especially the majority of the supporters here, Raymond. What was meant to be a good afternoon for many turned out to be an excellent afternoon for New Caledonia, in fact.
Yeah, definitely when you look at the field for the boy, John Aribulu. But New Caledonia again proving champions, this time number 8 for them. Number 8 that will be circled in the most successful. The final score here, New Caledonia 9, Solomon's 8.
And you can tell the New Caledonia, they know they have just gotten gold here, and what a way to win it in Solomon Islands' home ground, the National Stadium here. And you can tell by the players the way they react.